YouTube. I've got this little Dell Mini here, and I'm going to put this new screen on it because the screen is busted. And I'm going to take it apart. Solid state drive and LAN card. That makes a solid state drive. It doesn't say on the front. It's probably real tiny though. I'm just gonna put the whole screen assembly on there. That one was a little longer. Yeah, at least this is a really old machine that didn't sell for very much when it was new. But, oh my gosh, it is so not worth fixing. But she wants it fixed. So, I will fix it. That's 512 megabytes of RAM. And probably 16 gigabytes of storage space. That one just doesn't want to come out. I get to do some more gameplay videos here recorded here directly. I just ain't felt like it. Alright, this one screw is being stubborn. That's all the screws on the bottom there. Looks like it. Always one screw wants to spin in there and not come out. It's had a more magnetic screwdriver. This one's nice. I mean, I got it at Walmart. But oh, maybe it's not grabbing all to anything. Let's see. Keyboard. And there are more screws under the keyboard. And there's the keyboard. Tiny. Be right back. I'm back. I just wanted to get some tweezers to grab the screws. Get it down in the hole so I can pull the screw out. It'd be so much better if I had a big magnet on the screwdriver. There we go. That's why I don't just pull the front face off of this thing and replace the screen. And I looked all up and down the front face and I don't see any screws, and I'm not comfortable just cracking the plastic without undoing some screws. So this tells me it's glued together and you really aren't going to get it back together too well. Let's see if it'll crack open now. Yep. Yeah. Gotta be real careful when you're cracking open a laptop. Don't want to force it, because you might have always forgotten a screw, like I just did. The last thing you want to do is force it when you've forgotten a screw. Yeah. Now I need to... There's a little ribbon cable I need to get loose here. Something else you don't want to force is ribbon cables. That's another one. Or the things that hold them in place, because they break easily. And there's the top. now, that's what it looks like with the top off. Yeah, that screw was just turning in there because the doohickey that holds it in has come off. So I need to disconnect the wires from the Wi-Fi card here. Just like that. Those wires are coming out. Like that. Because they're connected to the screen. Happy little wires. Okay. And then there's another wire here connected to the screen. Just like that. It was right here. And it was connected there. Just disconnect all the wires from the screen. Just like that. Alright. And even if it's in the way, you can unhook it. Okay. Now it looks like there's only three screws actually holding the screen down, right here and right over here. Actually, it's only two screws. This screw's holding me down something else. Okay. Yeah. Nice. Alright. Just like that, the screen lifts off. Alright. Put the old screen to the side. Get the new screen. There. Now, whenever they want to fix a computer that's not worth fixing, I tell them it's not worth fixing. So, when they want to fix it anyway, I'm like, okay. You say so. Out the way. Lower the new screen down. Just like that. Screw it back down. These Wi-Fi antenna leads, poke them down through the hole here, just like that. Move them around where they're supposed to be. There's a hole down in here. Alright. Like so. And then just happy little wires. Yeah, I'm doing the Bob Ross thing. Plug this one back in. I'm upside down. Maybe I'm upside down. I was upside down. Alright. So this side's good. Alright. And then on this side, there's a wire here. It's the most tedious thing about fixing laptops. All the wires everywhere. That and all the little screws. Maybe it's upside down. I didn't think it was, but maybe it wasn't. I don't know. It was. Okay. I'll plug this wire back in because it was just simply in my way earlier. Well, it's still kind of in my way. I'm going to feed the wire back through where it was. The little grippers. And plug the wire back onto the board. Get in there. Make sure the little piece of tape that they put on there is taped down. Back in place that was in my way a minute ago. Now, wonder how hard it is to turn this thing on without the top. Very difficult because the power button is on the top. And the fun part is getting these little ribbons back in. Oops. So that's the fun part. Because sometimes you say oops. Little things in the side back in. There. Now, I'm going to put the battery in. Before I put any more screws in. And I'm going to notice that the battery is dead. So I'm going to have to be right back with the power adapter. Alright, I'm back. Now, let's check it out. Hold on, ready? On. This will make a lot of noise. Up there it goes. Whoop. All right. So I'm gonna cut it off and put it the rest of the way back together. Mouse still working? Yes. Windows XP, that's adorable. Yep. Oh, it's running AVG, that's so cute. Sorry, a phone call just interrupted my filming, but just testing the sound. Okay. So, I can turn this off, put it the rest of the way back together, and call it fixed. Windows XP, I love it. Intel Atom is probably a really early single core Intel Atom. It's probably slow as balls. Okay. Unplug the power. Take the battery back out. It's only put it in to turn it on and test it with, and it's dead anyway. But just to be sure, pull it out. Going to plug the Wi-Fi antennas back in. This is always fun, this tiny little snap. There we go, snap. Those wires. Okay. Good. Just like that. They poke out here and they come around here. And then they connect right there to the Wi-Fi card. There's an SD card slot like behind the battery. Place from. It's either an SD card slot or a... No, that's the SD card slot. I bet you could put an old SIM card in here and have like yeah, I bet you that's a SIM card slot. That's kind of cool. Screws out here. I'm going to start putting them back in. I could have done this live. I just didn't really think it was something to do live. Plus, it would have been a pain in the butt to do a live feed from over here. The computer's over there. Could have set up a laptop, I guess. This is a pretty easy one to work on, actually. You can't really mess up with the screws because they're, for the most part, all the same length. So. Another one of them ribbon cables. You're good. Close that up. Close that up. Keyboard. Okay. Keyboard has a couple of screws. Whoop. See you there. Need something heavier. If I put it in front of the phone, yeah, I'm like this. Out of the way of the camera, but I'll hold the thing up. Okay. Screw the keyboard down. Ooh, that's good type. Happy little keyboard. Be thinking, why do I watch this? Can I fix a keyboard? Can I fix a laptop? It's possible. You know, I can do it. Why not? You know, it's funny. My first job fixing laptops. I didn't really know how. See, I had been working on desktops for years. And they're pretty easy. But I needed a better job because I was working at a gas station and it sucked. So I got a job interview at an IT company, and they asked me, "Do you have any experience working on laptops?" And I smiled and I said, "Yes, I do." And they put a laptop in front of me, and I figured it out. Because, you know, I needed that job. So I think that it's very possible that you could do it too. I mean, I had a little experience with electronics and whatnot, but now that I taught myself on the job, on the fly, how to do this, I do it regularly. You may also be asking your question, can I get this guy to fix my laptop? And the answer is yep. I would be happy to. Cover back on. One thing I always loved, I'm being sarcastic when I say I always loved, is I would test it half apart and it would work. And then I'd put it all back together, turn it on, and it doesn't work. Alright, we're back together. I'm gonna plug her back in here. Oop. Got the power light there. Turn it on. It's so quiet, you don't know what it's on or not. There it is. Alright. What's her problem? Time and date. Oh. I probably just forgot because the battery's dead. Okay. F1 to resume. There's no F1 on this keyboard. Oh, okay. Function F1. Alright. It's the blue letters. Alright. I guess the keyboard's working. I'm just gonna test all the keys. It's so cute. I'm gonna see how much storage space this thing has. Details. Not the quickest thing in the world. Details. 16 gigabytes. Oh my gosh. Total size 14.3 gigabytes. space, free space, 5. Oh my gosh. Let me see if the Wi-Fi is doing good. It is. Wi-Fi is working good. Putting in the key here. Network key. This thing can even hook up to my router. It's so old. Acquiring. Oh, connected. Let's open up Firefox here. Happy little Firefox. They got Dropbox on this thing with a 14 gig flash drive on it. It's in Russian. Oh. Well, even though it's in Russian. The clock is wrong. That's why it's giving me fits. It is not February 2008. It is December 2016. December 2016, 19th. I don't know what time it is though. My phone is being used to record y'all, for record me. Close enough. Is it even charging? Charging. 0 remaining. Oh gosh, it's scanning for viruses. This is funny. Everything's in Russian. Dropbox, do me a favor and go away. Thank you. Okay. Well, yes, I want to cancel Dropbox. Yeah, it is that little slot in the back. It is for SIM cards. I see a T-Mobile thing on here. So, wow, they crammed Office 2003 on here. I'm impressed. Here. Oh my gosh. Well, that works too. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you later.